Hey YouTube, Martin Webb, Three Eagle Randomosity here today. It's the fall of the year, kids are going back to school, so I thought I would do a little history lesson, but not just for the kids, but for the grown-ups as well. I'm going to go over the Constitution of the United States of America. I want to send a shout out to the Houston kids. They seem to really enjoy my videos, so hello Houston kids. The First Amendment of the Constitution of the United States of America is the freedom of speech, press, religion, and petition. Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble, to petition the government for a redress of grievance. If you've got a problem with the government, you can peaceably assemble and petition them to change whatever laws you want. That don't mean rioting and looting. That means to peaceably discuss with them. And honestly, the freedom of speech and press, it is under attack right now. It's very subtle. If you're not politically correct, then you can't say what you want to say. The Second Amendment is the right to keep and bear arms. A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. In order for us to have all our amendments of the Constitution, we need the second one in there. If they take it away, then the rest of them will follow. And notice it says shall not be infringed on. It don't say may not or might not. It says shall not. That's plain and simple English. Third Amendment is conditions for quarters of soldiers. No soldier shall in time of peace be quartered in any house without the consent of the owner, nor in time of war, but in a manner to be prescribed by law. The fourth one is the right of search and seizure regulated. The right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated. Once again, shall not. And no warrants shall be issued but upon probable cause, supported by oath or affirmation, and particularly describing the place to be searched and the persons or things to be seized. If they want to come in and search your house, they have to have a search warrant. In order to get that, they have to have probable cause to do that. If on the search warrant it says search living room, that is the only room in that house they can search if it's specified. If they are hunting dope and they find an illegal gun, they cannot charge you with that because it was not in the search warrant. The Fifth Amendment to the Constitution, provisions concerning prosecution. No person shall be held to answer for a capital or otherwise infamous crime unless on a permanent or indictment of a grand jury. If they charge you with something, they have to present their evidence to a grand jury, and the grand jury decides whether you will be charged with that crime or not. Except in cases arising in the land or naval forces or in the militia, when an actual service in time of war or public danger, nor shall any person be subject for the same offense to be twice put in jeopardy of life or limb. If you go to court for a crime and they try you and the jury finds you innocent, they cannot come back and try you for that same crime again. Nor shall be compelled in any criminal case to be a witness against himself. That means they can't make you testify against yourself in a court of law. Nor be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor shall private property be taken for public use without just compensation. If the government, the state, city, county, whoever, wants your land, and they want your home, they cannot just take it unless they pay you what it's worth. That's the first five amendments to the Constitution of the United States of America. I wanted to throw this out for the kids. They need to learn this in school. I don't even know if they still teach it in school. So the kids can learn it, know what it means. Also, for a lot of the adults out there, they may have read it in school, heard it read in school, forgot it, don't remember it, or don't understand it. I would recommend you pull it up on the internet, read it, understand all of it. Know your rights as a United States citizen. I'll come back soon and read the other five to you and try to explain them a little bit in detail. Please like and subscribe. Remember, life is made of choices, and the choices you make determine the life you live. Until next time, stay safe.